Well, he also plays in a small ballpark too, with his home games, you know, 81 games in a very small ballpark. So he's not losing, I don't think, too much power.
Yeah.
Right. But yeah, I've seen him do it, and a lot of people are starting to embrace that new approach too at the major league level, sometimes at the college level as well, from what I'm noticing, just me. Be sure to subscribe to the show. Go ahead. Oh, Bo Bichette does do it, yes.
Bo Bichette's been doing it since really he came up, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yeah. He has. He did it in the minor leagues, too. Subscribe to the show. You know what to do. Of course, the Lab Epstein Hitting Podcast YouTube page, so you can watch the show, full episodes, previous episodes, and all that good, happy stuff. I was going to say a bad word today, but I know that we're around youth, so I can't really use too much of a bad word. Yeah.
She's never heard any bad words, so I appreciate you doing that.
Anytime. Yeah, anytime.
You've never said around the house.
I've heard that. Episode 103, keeping it simple. Just as a baseline, let's get into our topic today. Keeping it simple. How does a hitter at any age really go about creating a baseline for keeping it simple so they don't get too much into their heads?
Yeah, you know, at a young age, my dad used to talk about look fast or slow. Like, don't get crazy. Don't sit there. You know, if you're playing 12-year-old ball, baseball or softball, don't get crazy. Oh, I'm going to look middle away. I'm going to look middle in. I'm going to look, you know what? Like, look fast or slow. I'm going to sit on a fastball and I'm not going to be late on it. Yeah. And that served us well, really, until we were probably 16, 17 years old. And then all of a sudden it was like, okay, you know, maybe we can dice up the plate a little bit more. He also told me that when he was in the big leagues, they would tip pitches with runners on second. They weren't tipping the pitch itself. They were tipping location. Is it going to be inside or outside? Mm-hmm. And they figured that if they knew, okay, the pitch, the catcher's setting up inside, you know, and it's, you know, whatever, a right-handed thrower against a right-handed batter, they knew it was going to be a fastball, you know, or if it was a left-handed one, you know, a left-handed hitter, then, you know, maybe it's a slider, maybe it's a fastball, but, you know, that was it. Like, they weren't getting too crazy with it. So sometimes you want to get crazy. Sometimes you want to sit off speed and you want to sit middle away, you know, maybe with two strikes or something like that, but every player is different. And I think that's the most important thing, is that you can't let players, you know, like, get in their own head, you know, they're thinking too much, and then all of a sudden they start taking pitches. So that's the worst thing that can happen. So each player has to be different. Like, hey, this is a player that's too heady. They think too much. They get in their own dome. All right. All I want you to do is, you know, get up there and swing the bat, look for a strike. I don't care what it is, and explode on it. And then some players, if you give them that basic advice, they'll swing at everything. So now all of a sudden it's like, okay, maybe we need to narrow it down a little bit. And okay, look middle away, you know, or look middle in. But you have to know what kind of player you are and how that player adjusts to different pitches.
There was a time there, two things. Great points you made there, but also there was a time there where your screen just went black and I only heard you. And that was like my, that was like my 20 seconds to shine, though. I was all alone on the screen. So on YouTube, if people watch this on the YouTube page, it was all me. I was time to shine, baby.
That's probably when the ratings will go up the most. If you check the rate, I'm sure that's when, as soon as I came back, it's likely when everything went downhill. Luckily, Vivian was here. Call had come in and it did something. I don't know what it did. Vivian hit the button to bring me back.